in a little more than 10 years, we turned this industry from about 1,000 banks to 100. Mm-hmm. Which other country in the Europe has done something like that? Think about Germany, for example. In any case, we have done a big part of the road we have to do. A lot of consolidation has been done. Some room for more consolidation is available, but the level of competition, the level of efficiency is certainly increased significantly.
So why am I still terrified about the delinquencies in the Italian banking system, the number of zombie loans out there? But let's face it, with zero and negative interest rates from the ECB as well, there are companies and delinquencies and debts that are still there that just shouldn't be there 10 years after the GFC.
And the length of the recession between 2008, 2012, 13, 14, I mean, created this enormous mass of non-performing exposures. But a good part of it, at least half of it, has been sold through capital increases on the one side and through sale of this position on the other side. Today, we are not far from European averages. Obviously, what is happening because of COVID will increase the level of bad debts throughout Europe and probably throughout the world. But today, the system is certainly much better equipped to manage this. Also because some specialized banks, like ours, have been created with new, totally new paradigms.
We'll come to Illimity in a moment's time, but let's just carry on the vein about the position of the European average compared with, say, the US average. And look, I'm no sycophant to US banks, but one thing I admire about the American banking model, perhaps aided by the regulatory situation, is that when there is a loss to be taken on a debt, they take it earlier on. They take it way earlier on average than potentially we'll see that in Europe, i.e. they see a potential problem, they take the downgrade, they take the impairment, whereas Europe waits years potentially for that impairment to come through in the books. It makes them far more fleet of foot than we are in Europe.
No, you're right. The main reason for this situation to be created was fiscal tax ones, because it was not possible to clean the books in a fiscally acceptable way. Now this has been increased, and the calendar provisioning, that means the rules that the ECB and the European Union introduced to push these exposures out of the balance sheets, will make the European and the US situations much, much more similar.
So let's just say something happens and we get away from the Japanification of Europe, where we have a lower growth rate, but we see lower for longer in terms of interest. Let's say we get, and I don't know if there's going to be a dramatic move to the downside in terms of the economy or a dramatic move to the upside. Something's going to change at some stage. Will the banking sector cope, i.e. with A, higher interest rates and potentially higher inflation, or B, a more depression-like situation given where we are with the level of debts?
I expect interest rates to remain very low for quite a period of time. And
So that would be an admission of failure then in the project?
No, that is acceptance of the situation both in the US and in Europe. Obviously, monetary policy cannot cope with the situation by itself. I mean, we have to put together monetary policy, very loose ones, with the fiscal policy, because today is the day of the investments, in my opinion. If we want to turn the situation, if we want to avoid quite a depression possible around the corner, we have to concentrate the efforts of the single each country and of the European Union on investments. Investment in innovation, investment in education, investment in infrastructure.